And so, dear ones, it is necessary to understand our knowledge and to apply our knowledge in your personal experience so that you can gain direct access to this process within you, for that is how you will create the change. Changing the concepts within your subconscious mind through the accumulation of new energy, new information, will not give you the freedom that you truly desire. It is simply replacing old concepts with new concepts while you continue to remain a prisoner of this audible thought flow within you, as you continue to stay in a state of semi-consciousness, being highly influenced by the thoughts and ideas, the judgments within your subconscious mind. And so, dear ones, practice meditation to understand that you are not these thoughts, to feel the energy flow within you, and to learn how to keep this energy stable, open, at your deepest energy center. Thought, dear one, the energy of yourself, the base energy of mind, the deepest dimension of your human being, comes from the spiritual heart. This is the deepest energy center within you. This, dear ones, is where your eternal spiritual energy, your eternal creative energy, the energy of life, the blissful energy of love, this is where this creative power first enters into your human vehicle. It is the spiritual heart, the doorway to your eternal self, through which this energy flows into your mortal human experience. You see, dear ones, we have a multidimensional human being. We have the physical body existing within this dimension as it is perceived through the five senses, the five physical senses. And then we have an emotional body as it is perceived in this emotional realm of feeling. It is an astral realm of energies, and we have senses within this astral realm that give us the ability to perceive the range of emotional experiences. These, dear ones, can be called the chakras, for they give us the perception of the different emotions, just as the five senses give us the perception of the different physicality aspects. And so, dear one, your chakras allow you to perceive the emotional energy within you as a multidimensional human being. This is the middle layer of your human energy system, and it is fully connected with and fully interacting with the physical aspect of your being. A deeper layer, dear one, is that which we call the mind, or the causal dimension within you. For that is the deepest aspects of your human system. That is where the layers of unconscious, subconscious, conscious, and superconscious mind exist within you. Your mind, dear one, is far more than your audible thoughts. For the unconscious mind is silent. It is simply movement of energy that is far beyond your current recognition and awareness, unless you expand your awareness and begin to purify this aspect of you by bringing that which is unconscious into consciousness, therefore awakening yourself more deeply. Largely, dear one, the unconscious mind operates the functions of your human body, the basic foundation of how your emotions, physical organs, physical senses, how all of yourself operates. For as you gain greater mastery over this unconscious layer of yourself, you will be able, dear one, to alter the function of your human being. This is how yogis have stopped their breath. This is how yogis have stopped their heart. This is how yogis have dissolved all information from their five senses and turned their attention away from the external stimulus and into their own inner self. As you, dear one, expand your awareness, you will reach more deeply into these unconscious layers of yourself, bringing them into consciousness and purifying them. In the subconscious mind, dear one, we have the audible thought, the thought stream that continues to occur. We have within the subconscious layer our memories, our stored beliefs, our social conditioning. The subconscious mind contains that which we gathered from our experience in this world and have stored within us. It influences our conscious experience, yet it is not deeply embedded within our human self, so it can be easily changed, easily exposed to our awareness, easily healed, purified, easily aligned to our conscious goals. And then, dear one, there is the conscious state, in which the mind is silent, and yet the mind can choose to create thought. In this conscious state, you are here, living in this moment with whatever is happening in this moment. It is simply your present conscious awareness. Often, the subconscious activities are influencing your conscious awareness, for your own awareness is often split between living in a subconscious state, being at the mercy of your ego, and living in a conscious state. You experience semi-consciousness, for you wander between unconsciousness, as chosen by the subconscious influences, and consciousness, as chosen by your free will. And so you live a fraction of both, most often during your life. Meditation, dear one, is the act of empowering our conscious mind, and then learning to purify and silence our subconscious mind. And in doing so, we live more consciously within this world. And then, dear one, there is the aspect of higher mind, of superconsciousness. This is a state in which your own individual self begins to expand, in which your subconscious mind is sufficiently purified to no longer hold you in states of unconscious awareness during your daily life. You no longer get trapped in the thought stream of your mind, but instead, after being able to remain in the state of consciousness constantly during your life, you will be able to access something greater. A greater intelligence. You will see and understand that as you remain in the state of consciousness, that there is a greater intelligence than you controlling your experience, influencing the experience of all life. You will begin to see the greater workings of this world and of yourself. And in this way, you will explore and experience the content of the higher mind.